I was afraid that all my memories were lost in time. But now I remember, and I can tell you how it all began. It was a beautiful summer, and the year was 1978. We were headed to the coast to enjoy the great outdoors. My boyfriend Mark, my best friend Connie, and me. There was a moment when I thought the world was perfect, and nothing could make me happier. Mark had proposed to me beneath the redwoods. My joy was suddenly shattered by Connie's scream. Mark and I raced back to camp. When I saw him, the only thing I wanted to know was, what happened here?
I'll hold this while you make sure that Connie's okay.
What happened to her?
I don't know. Lucky for us, I think she's only knocked out.
She's hurt. I need a bandage and some water.
Check the bus. Here, take the keys.
Oh man, the door's jammed again. After Connie got injured, we decided to take her to Eureka when that monstrous raven attacked us. Surely I would have been caught. But then, all of a sudden, I lost ground and started falling down. I thought it was over. But it wasn't. When I woke up, it was almost pitch black. I didn't know where I was, and what troubled me more was that I didn't know what had happened to Mark and Connie.
Poor man. But wait, what's there in his hand? What is this place? A flooded burial chamber in the middle of a redwood forest? Having no other option, I continued forward through the dungeons. Finally, I managed to reach some larger chamber with visible daylight. It's Connie, tied and imprisoned. What psychopath is behind all this? And where is Mark? Connie, who did this to you? Where is Mark?
The man... He kept us in some chapel.
What chapel?
The Blood Tree Raven.
Connie? Connie! I finally managed to reach the surface, next to Whitmarsh's mansion. Closer to danger, the farther from harm. However, it was that giant tree that first caught my attention, and not without reason. I saw him there. Whitmarsh. It was clear he was the one pulling the strings here. The monstrous raven was only his servant. But he wasn't the one that was really drawing my attention. It was Mark. Unconscious, but alive. Whitmarsh took him to a chamber under the tree. I had to hurry. A magical sign locks the door? What is this? Dracula's mansion? My fiancé was nearby, but so was the raven and its master. My only hope was to find and free him. The monstrous raven is guarding that tree. I'd better find another way. This man is deadly serious. He had planned it all. I must stop him. What is he doing? Preparing some kind of magic ritual? Summoning? If I revert the ritual, perhaps I can command the raven to leave. Someone is going to great lengths to find the priest. Why?